Here in game two, number 31, Cameron Sistrunk.
Back over here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network in game four of the four-game series between Garden City and Seward County. Garden City loses their third game this afternoon of a final score of 14-3 after Seward County blew out a fourth inning, scoring 9 runs in the fourth inning. 3 back in the third and 2 in the second. As Garden City looking to make some big changes in the lineup and pitching. Let's go through your starting lineup, starting with Seward County. Nothing changed really. It's gonna be the number 22 of KP Warner, number 8 of Johnson, number 14 of Grant, 35 of Bozvert, the number 3 of AJ Folds, 11 of Peter Goldie, the number 1 of Berberick, the number 24 of Gallardo, number 5 of Armijo, and the number 9 of Turner. Pitching for the Seward Saints will be the number 9. The number 9 of Turner. For Garden City, nothing changed really on the lineup. Number 4 of Glosson, number 8 of Ryan Munez, number 25 of Gardner, number 39 of Ramos, number 7 of Tyler Barth, number 30 of Marlowe, 26 of Rodriguez, number 14 of Mason Mitchell, number 8 of Jamison, and the number 31 of Sistrunk will be out on the mound for Garden City. Marlowe still the catcher for the Bronkbusters. And the Seward County Saints will start off at the top of the lineup here in the top of the first. It's the number 22 of KP Warner.
First pitch is at 3:19 p.m. It is 87 degrees and partly sunny.
It's that first pitch too high for Sistrunk. Second pitch right down the pipe on a curve. KP Warner struck out in the first inning back in the first game on a look, then contributed to 2 more runs back in the fourth and fifth inning. Actually, no, both of his runs came in the fourth as he went right back through the top of the lineup. So Warner looking to get stuff started for Seward. That pitch, strike called, now on a 2-2 count. That one fouled off behind the grandstands. So still on a 2-2 count. Garden City went through 4 pitchers back in the first game. All 4 of which not even pitching for a full 2 innings. That's just Sistrunk. That one hit right out to third base. Should be an easy throw all the way to first. And they get the first out. But Garden City went through 4 pitchers. Started out with Petrowski, then went to McCandless, then Acosta, Ortiz, and finally rounding out back in the first game was Esty. But a terrible start for Garden City in the third game. So Werner on a line drive to third base gets thrown out for the first out in the top of the first. Now it's going to be the number 8 of Johnson up to bat. That pitch right down the pipe there, strike called. Pitch there, right down the pipe again on the curve ball, second strike on Johnson. Sistrunk off to a good start. That pitch too high. That ball fouled off. Still 1-2 on the count. That That pitch on the outside, Marlowe had to chase it. So now 2-2 on Johnson. Garden City leads this series 2-1 after winning the first two games down in Liberal. First game was 8-5, second game 17-5, then Seward County comes back today, wins the third game 14-3 just a little bit ago. That one fouled off, stayed in line, but finally went out of bounds after the north wind caught it, pushed it back out of foul line. So Johnson putting up a fight here on a 2-2 count with one out after a line drive to third and thrown out. That was KP Warner. Another line drive right on the third baseline. It'll go foul before it gets to the third base. And Johnson putting up a fight with Sistrunk out on the mound. That one popped up right in the right field, shallow. Two runners going forward. It's going to go out on the foul line. It'll finally drop on the dirt outline that rounds out behind and around Williams Stadium. So Johnson still on the plate for the Seward County Saints. Johnson was a big contributor for Seward County back in the first game. Johnson had a double play in the first inning, then had a single home run back in the third, was RBI'd in the fourth. That one hit out in the right field. And it's going to go foul over the wall. So Johnson put up a heck of a fight, was RBI'd in the fourth inning, and then made it, was left on third in the fourth as well, as he made it all the way back through the lineup for his contributions into the first game. Technically the third game of the series, but first game of the afternoon. So Johnson's still working on a 2-2 count and five foul balls. That pitch on the inside still swings at it, and it fouled off again. That one now this time heading over to the Bronkbuster dugout. Sistrunk on the 2-2 pitch, and Sistrunk will nail Johnson in the back and walk Johnson.
The catcher number 14, Wyatt Grant.
As now the number 14 of Wyatt Grant up to bat for Seward County. Grant also contributing to 14-run game earlier this afternoon for Seward County. Was hit in back in the third inning, then was RBI'd in the fourth, and was left on first in the fourth after making his way all the way back through the lineup. So one out for Seward County, Johnson out on first. Here's the pitch from Sistrunk. Popped up right over Sistrunk. It'll go to Munez to second, easy throw to first, and there's the second out. So Johnson makes it over to second, but Grant will be thrown out at first.
The first baseman, number 35, Braden Boisvert.
Fielding for Garden City, behind the plate is Marlowe, Tyler Barth out on first, Munez to second, Jameson on the shortstop, and Ibrahim Rodriguez out on third. From left to right in the outfield, it's Glosson, Mitchell, and Gardner. On the mound, it's Cameron Sistrunk. As Jeff Marlowe going to go talk to Sistrunk out on the mound. As now the number 35 of Boisvert up to bat. He had a heck of a game. Had a single home run, or excuse me, had a double home run back in the third in the first game this afternoon. Then contributed on a walk-in run in the fourth and was popped out in the left field and got the second out. Or excuse me, yeah, the second out. Actually, third out, rather, in that fourth inning back in the first game. So, Bravaire. Another big contributor for Seward County. Seward County only had one opening in the depth chart back in the first game, as Cantu was the only one unable to bring any runs in for Seward County. Struck out three times, two of them on a look and the other one on swinging. That is now a 3-0 count on Bovaire. So Bovaire on a 3-0, two outs for Seward County here in the first. And that one on the inside, he'll walk. As now the number three of A.J. Folds. Let's go over his first game for you. A.J. Folds was on fifth in the lineup. RBI'd in the second inning.
Number three, A.J. Folds.
Was hit in on an RBI from his teammate Peter Goldie to start off Seward County's first run back in the first game. Pop out in the center field in the third inning, got out, and then contributed in the fourth on a run in. Now first pitch there for him is a strike. Beautiful afternoon here in Garden City, 86 degrees, winds out of the north at around 14, 15 miles an hour. As that cold front now coming through most parts of western Kansas. Going to be expecting severe weather later this afternoon. So the storm's expected to start to fire up in western Kansas and move along all the way to the east part. Garden City and Seward trying to get this doubleheader out of the way before that rain starts to pop up here in western Kansas. Bovaire out on first, Johnson on second. That pitch too low, 1-1 on the count now. Excuse me, 2-1, rather. As Sistrunk nearing his 30th pitch. That one swinging a hit, fouled off. That one's going to go all the way over to the Little Caesars parking lot, almost. Here over at Williams Stadium. That one had a lot of power behind it. That pitch on the outside. So now a full count unfolds. That one's swinging a hit. That one's going to go foul right before the first base. And the runners will turn right back around and head back to their previous base. Still Bovaire on first, Johnson on second. Two outs for Seward County as A.J. Folds on a full count. Folds with one of those more iconic names almost reminds me of A.J. Foyd. Almost want to keep saying A.J. Foyd, one of the more infamous IndyCar drivers back in the day. That one, line drive right out in the left field. It's going to have wind behind it. It's going to go foul. And Abraham Rodriguez was going to go try for the diving play there, but decided not to go for it. So another foul ball as A.J. Folds still up to bat on a full count with two outs bearing down Seward County here in the first. Now Fold signaling he wants to go for a bunt, possibly. try to advance his runners. Here's the pitch from Sistrunk right down the pipe, but looked too low there, and a no call from the umpire, so Folds will walk. Now you got bases loaded. This is how Seward County started off the running.
11, Peter Goldie.
Back in the first game. So now Johnson on third, Bovera on second, A.J. Folds on first, and no other than Peter Goldie. Goldie was able to bring in a lot of RBIs back in that first game. Let's go over Goldie's first game. Was left on third base, but had the RBI hit to bring in A.J. Folds back in the second inning, back in the first game. Then was left on first in the third inning, then contributed to the runs in the fourth inning, and was left on first in the fifth. As Goldie starts on a 1-0 count. Swing and a miss. So Goldie on a 1-1 count here. As Sistrunk trying to close out the first inning here. That pitch too low. That one popped out right into the gap out in left field. Glosson will stubble with it, and it'll bring in the first two runs. Johnson will come home, and Bovera will bring it home. As Goldie makes a double play there on the two-run RBI.
Designated hitter number one is Sam Berberick.
That's now the DH of Sam Berberick. Up to the plate for Seward County. First pitch, a strike there. Garden City dropping their game earlier to number three, Butler County. Garden City softball playing in the Region 6 tournament over in Dodge City. Now playing in the elimination game. It's the top of the fifth. Garden City and Barton are tied 5-5 after Michaela Insignia has hit her third home run of the postseason back in the third. That pitch on the outside, make it one and two on the count. Big pitch here from Cameron Sistrunk out on the mound. 1-2 on the count, two outs bearing. Runners on second and first. So that pitch on the outside, make it 2-2 now. So Folds out on second, Peter Goldie on first. That one fouled off behind home plate. Garden City football on a bye week this week. They'll play number 9 Coffeyville next Saturday at home and then on the road for the final game of the regular season as they'll head to El Dorado to play Butler County for their final game of the regular season. Garden City is 5-1 on the season. Their only loss coming to number 1 ranked Hutchison. questionable rest of the season for Garden City, as they were barely able to beat Dodge City 34-24 last Saturday at home. As Devin Larson, the starting quarterback for Garden City, out with a shoulder injury, and now it's up to Mike Irwin to get Garden City through the rest of the season and try to take Garden City into a postseason run. So full count for Barabick with two outs. Big pitch here. That one, swing and hit right into a gap. Seward will bring in another runner. And it's the number three of A.J. Folds that'll bring it home. So Burbick with a run, one run RBI. He'll put runners on the corners now. It's Goldie on third, Burbick on first. Now the number 24, Gallardo, smashes that one out into center field, and it'll be a home run. It'll bring in two runners. As now Goldie will be hit in. Berbick will be hit in, and Gallardo will contribute three runs. Here in the first on a three-run home run. Seward County opening up this game.
The third baseman, number five, Richard.
On a worse start than the first one this afternoon. 6-0 now, as the number five of Armijo up to bat. That pitch in the dirt. Armijo on the 2-1 count. Two outs for Seward County. And a strike call there. That pitch on the outside too low. Make it a full count now for Armijo. Garden City needs to get the third and final out here before they allow Seward County to go back to the top of the lineup. Here's the pitch. Popped up right into right field. Should be an easy out. Two runners running for it, and it'll be caught out from Gardner out in right field. But Seward County opens up the first inning with six runs. We head to the bottom of the first. Your score is 6-0 here on the Rockbuster Sports Network.
for the Mustangs. Swinging in the bottom of the first inning, the left fielder number four, Colin Lawson.
Back here on the Bronxbuster Sports Network, Dalton Janicek bringing you Region 6 baseball this afternoon. Garden City in their fourth and final game of the series between Seward County. They lead 2-1 after Seward County winning their first game here earlier this afternoon. That's Glosson up to bat. Seward County picking up where they left off back on the first game, opening up with a 6-run first inning. That's Glosson starting off on a 1-1 count. And a swing and a miss on Glosson. Updated score from Region 6 softball this afternoon. Garden City in the elimination bracket now. Top of the fifth, Barton now leads Garden City 6-5 after Madison Baylor put a solo shot out into left field, but Cougars up as Glosson will strike out.
The second base number 8, Ryan Muniz.
Glosson strikes out. As now the number 8 of Ryan Muniz up to bat. Muniz's first game. Hit in an RBI to bring Glosson in. That was about it. Was left on first in the fourth. He'll get thrown out at first. Now 25, Will Gardner up.
Right fielder number 25, Will Gardner.
That first pitch really slow there, right down the pipe. That should have been an easy hit for Gardner. So strike there. That one fouled off.
Go, Will.
Oh, and 2 on the count. That one popped up. Right behind home plate on the left side. The catcher, that was the 14 of Will Grant getting that third and final out. So Garden City goes 3-3 down here. After Glosson strikes out and then 2 pop-ups.
The Busters in the bottom of the first. You go to the top of the second.
Seward County leads 6-0 as they get ready to the bat again here on the Rockbuster Sports Network.
Tears on the mausoleum floor, bloodstains the Colosseum doors.
out for Seward here in the top of the second inning. This is center fielder number 22, KB Warner.
Back here on the Bronkbusters Sports Network, Dalton Janicek bringing you Region 6 baseball this afternoon in sunny Garden City, Kansas. Garden City looking to close out the four-game series with Seward. They lead it 2-1. As now, a new pitcher out on the mound. It's going to be Noah McCandless. McCandless pitched for about 1.2 innings back in the first game. That's Garden City. This has been a struggle all season. That would be the bullpen. That one smashed out in the center field. That one's got a lot of wind behind it. And it'll bounce right out in the center field. It'll be a double for number 22, KP Warner. And they're going to say he's got to go, or no. Just kidding. Standing off his equipment to first base coach. Thought they were telling him to go back to first. But Warner will stay out on second base. As now the number 8 of Johnson up to bat. Johnson, the first run to come in for Seward County in the first inning. That one popped up right in the right field. Gardner on the run. It's going to be way foul, and it'll bounce out of territory there. But Gardner was trying to get it and try to get an easy out. As the wind coming out of the north now starting to push those balls more foul. So 0-1 on the count. McCandless pitch right down the pipe. Fastball, strike called. Make it 0-2 now. Garden City's got to get some relief out of the bullpen if they're going to try to make it a 3-1 on the series with Seward County. Also give credit to Seward County. They've been able to hit really well. That one popped out right in the right field again. Gardner on the run. It's well foul. And it'll bounce out again. So Johnson back on the plate, still on an 0-2 count. Marlowe's got a slide for it on that one. So 1-2 on the count. That pitch on the inside. So 2-2 now. Canlis went to go for the throw at second, try to get Warner out, but changed his mind. That wasn't a balk. He kept that back foot planted. Now here's the 2-2 pitch. Right to McCandless. He got a piece of it with the glove to slow it down in the infield. So keeps Seward County from scoring, but it'll advance Warner out to third. And now Grant will get on at first. McCandless got a piece of that ball with his glove, but couldn't get a big grip on it as it went over his head, and it was recovered by Munez at second. That's now the number 35 of Beauvert. Back up to bat. Beauvert contributing big time for Seward County Saints back in the first game this afternoon and already here in the second. Wind starting to pick up now, more out of the north. That one hit into a gap out in the center right field, and it'll bring in Warner for another run. Now your score 7-0 here in the top of the second. Now Beauvert on first, and
first baseman 35, Braden Beauvert.
Grant out on second. Strike called there on Beauvert. So correction, it's Johnson out on second, Grant on first, and Beauvert still up to bat. That one swing and hit right behind home plate, fouled off. So Beauvert still on a 1-2 count. That one swinging a hit, line drive right on the third baseline. Be another foul ball. Two runners on, first and second. No outs for Seward County here in the top of the second inning. They lead 7-0. As Beauvert still fighting on home plate. Trying to advance his runners. Canlis agrees with the call. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Popped up, but it's going to go foul on the right field. But Barth on the back pedal step gets the first out. But Johnson will head over to third. And Grant stay on first, as now the number 3 of A.J. Folds back up to bat for Seward County.
The left fielder number 3, A.J. Folds,
contested for a run back in the first inning. First pitch there, strike called. Swing and a miss on Folds. So 0-2 now. McCandless starting to find that strike zone, starting to figure out what he likes. Pitch on the outside. Folds was a part of Goldie's 2-run RBI back in the first inning, but back in the first game, he contributed after walking in the second inning as he smashes that one out in the right field. That one way gone out into Kansas or Campus Avenue. And it'll be a three-run home run for A.J. Folds. As he'll bring in Johnson and Grant. And Seward County has been ruthless this afternoon, winning 14-3 back in the first game this afternoon. And now up 10-0 already, and it's only the top of the second inning. And Finnegan, head coach for Garden City, is going to head out to the mound, and we expect the call to the bullpen. We'll take it with him. Be back in a minute here on the Bronkbusters Sports Network.
Now pitching for Garden City, number 6, Raul Garcia. Right fielder number 11, Peter Goldie.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, Garden City trailing 10-0 here in the bottom of the second inning as Seward County has put it lights out. Since the second inning back in the first game this afternoon. Now Garden City on their third pitching change as it's now going to be the number 6 of Raul Garcia. Out on the mound for the Bronkbusters. They've got one out. Off of Bovair's pop up. 2-1 on the count for Goldie. That pitch almost hitting Goldie as it was on the inside, 3-1 now. And Goldie will walk now. That's now the designated hitter.
The designated hitter number one, Sam Berberick.
Berberick. Berberick hit an RBI back in the first inning. Bringing in his teammate AJ Folds. That one popped out. Foul ball right behind the Bronkbuster dugout. That pitch too low. Berberick on a 1-1 count, still one out for Seward County with Peter Goldie out on first base. Garcia will throw to first, not a lot of effort behind it. Wind starting to pick up more out of the north. Pitch there, right down the pipe, strike called. Seward County fans didn't agree with that call. One of the slower pitches from Garcia, but it was a changeup and caught Berberick off guard. And Garcia will strike out Berberick on the slider way outside in the bottom left corner. But Berberick will swing out.
The shortstop, number 24,
George Gallardo. Now the number 24 of Gallardo up to bat for Seward County. Gallardo hit a three-run home run back in the first inning. Also had a steal from third base to home to contribute for a run back in the first game, then was walked in the fourth inning and was left out on second in the fifth back in the first game. He's had himself a resume building afternoons versus the Bronkbusters. Garcia on the throw to first. Goldie will stay on first as he got back in time. So 0-1 on the count for Gallardo. A high change up there, too high. Now 1-1. Pitch on the inside. Gallardo thought about swinging at it, but kept. After Garcia shows Gallardo the fastball, hasn't put down the slider yet. See what Garcia wants to do here with it. There's the pitch. Slide up there. And the slider works for Garcia, and he'll get the third strikeout. Or excuse me, second strikeout. And he leaves a runner on first, but still allowing four runs here in the second inning for Garden City. See what they can do in the bottom of the second. Your score 10-0 here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
Thank you. that's a sad song. But when I ain't joking, do it sound like I'm kidding. I've been making like 2,000 nigga. So high up through the clouds, I'm swimming.
Leading off the Busters here in the bottom of the second inning, the designated hitter number 39, Miguel Ramos.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network. As Garden City trails 10-0 here in the bottom of the second inning. Seward County opened it up, 6 runs in the first and 4 in the second. As now the number 39 of Ramos up to bat for the Bronkbusters. Here's how Seward County fields this afternoon in the fourth and final game of the series. Grant behind the plate. Bozvert out on first, Johnson on second. That one hit into the infield, right to Gallardo, get the first out. But for Seward County fielding, it's Grant behind the plate. Bozvert on first, Johnson on second, Gallardo shortstop. Armijo on third, then left to right out in the outfield. It's AJ Foltz, Warner out in center, and Peter Goldie out in right field. As now, number 7 of Tyler Barth up to bat. This is his first at-bat this afternoon in the fourth game. Barth had a pop out in the left field back in the first game in the second inning, then struck out in the fourth. This is his first at-bat here in the final game. Second pitch, right down the middle, strike called. That was a slower pitch there from Turner. That one finally popped out in the center field. Going to have a lot of hang time. And it'll be caught out from the shortstop. That was Gallardo on the run. Now the number 30 of Jeff Marlowe up to bat.
Jeff Marlowe.
Marlowe the catcher for Garden City. Marlowe had a single back in the first game. In the first inning. He was left on in that inning as well. That was actually in the second inning. Was left on, then had nothing else throughout the game. As he opens up on a 1-0 count after that ball being on the outside. That pitch, fastball right down the middle, strike call. That ball fouled off behind the home grandstands. Make it 1-2 now with 2 outs on Garden City. No runners on bases. That pitch too low. Now 2-2. Here's the full count pitch. That one fouled off. Marlowe trying to keep Garden City alive here in the bottom of the second with a full count, 2 outs pending. There's the pitch, hit right out to center field. It's going to go right to Warner. Should be an easy out there, and it is. Garden City goes 3 up, 3 down here in the bottom of the second. Your score 10-0. Seward County leads. We'll be back in 1 minute from the top of the third on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
Yeah. This album is dedicated For all the teachers that told me I had my mouth tonight. For all the people that lived above the buildings that I was hustling for, that called the police on when I was trying to make some money to feed my daughter. So all my people in the struggle, you know what I'm saying? So it was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Something pepper and heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, rap attack, Mr. Magic Mall and Mall. I let my tape rock to my tape pop. Smoking weed and bamboo, sipping on private stock. Way back when I had the red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping Duke? The hard, you never thought that hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight cause I rhyme tight. Time to get paid, blow up like the World Trade. Born sinner, the opposite of a winner. Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? Beast of Raw G, Brucey B, Kitchen Free. Funk Master Flex, Love Buck, Star Ski. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. Call a grip, same number, same but it's all good. And if you don't know, now you know.
Leading out for Seward here in the top of the third inning is the third baseman to revive Richard Amio.
Back here on the Bruntbuster Sports Network, Seward County now back up to bat here in the top of the third. They lead Garden City 10-0 here already in this fourth and final game of the four-game series. That one, line drive right to Munez, I believe. That was the number 5 over Mio.
The center fielder, number 22, K.P. Warner.
As now we head back to the top of the lineup, it'll be K.P. Warner, the number 22 for Seward County. Raul Garcia still on the mound for the Bronkbusters. Had two strikeouts back in the second inning in his debut this afternoon. That one swinging a hit right to Rodriguez on third. Throw to second. They look for the double play. Too late for the first base from the throw from Munez. And so Amio will be thrown out at second, and Warner will stay on first. It's now the number 8 is Johnson up to bat. So Armio gets thrown out at second off of a fielder's choice. That pitch there, strike. Johnson opens up on an 0-1 count. That one, line drive right up the mound. That's going to go out in the center field. That was off the bat of Johnson. So now Warner will go out to second, and Johnson is on first. With number 14 of Grant up the bat.
Number 14, Wyatt Grant.
Johnson has made it home in the first and in the second. Now he's on first base. As Warner is out on second, he made it home in the second inning. Seward County allowing no holes really in the lineup. The only hole back in the first game was off of the catcher of Cantu. He had three strikeouts, two of them on looks, and the third one on a swing. Garden City softball season coming to an end, unfortunately, as Barton County wins 6-5 in the elimination round. Garden City played number 3 Butler this morning in a really close game. 3-2 was the final score from that game, and Barton County will advance into the next round of the elimination bracket side of the Region 6 tournament down in Dodge City as they win over Garden City 6-5 Garden City held that number one spot in the West Division of the Kansas Jayhawk Conference for a majority of the season. And Amy Schmeckpepper, the head coach for Garden City softball in her first season as well, definitely a big bounce back for that program. So Grant on a 2-1 count with one out here in the top of the third. Here's Garcia on the windup. That one's swinging a hit right over the infield into a gap, center right field, and it'll bring in at least another run. Now Seward County pushing. They were going to go for two, but Johnson held up. So Warner gets hit in on an RBI off of Grant. Seward County just increasing this lead here in the top of the third.
Number 35, Braden Wavere.
So now Johnson out on third and Grant on second. As now the number 35 of Braden Bravere up to bat. Wavere brought in a run in the first, was left out on first in the second. Here's the opening pitch. That one, line drive right over Garcia again as Jamison will pick it up and get the out thrown out at first. So he gets rid of Boisvert on the throw from the shortstop. As now the number three of A.J.
The left fielder, number three, A.J. Folds.
A.J. Folds. Up to bat, Folds had a walk in the first and then a three-run home run in the second inning to contribute for Seward County's 12-some runs here, 10 hits. It's just the top of the third. Marlowe wanted to go to third base, but Rodriguez wasn't there on the cover. That ball too low in the bottom left corner. So make it a 2-1 on the count for Folds. Still two outs for Seward County with a runner on third. That's Grant. That pitch right down the pipe, but a little too high there for Garcia. Here's Garcia on the 3-1 windup pitch. That one, dropper there. Put the changeup on Folds. And now make it a full count with two outs. Folds has got to be careful here. They want to keep the running going. Here's the full count pitch from Garcia. Swing and it fouled off behind home plate. So Folds will stay alive here. Swing and a hit, fouled off again for Folds. Here's the full count pitch again. That one fouled off. So AJ Fold's putting up a fight. Out there on the plate. Still two outs for Seward County. They've got 12 runs so far this afternoon off of 10 hits. And a swing and a miss. Garcia will strike out AJ Fold and get the Bronkbusters out of another bad inning. Your score, 12-0. Garden City trails as they head in the bottom of the third here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
Here in the bottom of the third inning, the third baseman number 26, Ibrahim Rodriguez.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, Dalton Janicek bringing you Region 6 baseball this afternoon in Garden City as the Bronkbusters take on the Seward County Saints in the fourth and final game of the four-game series. Garden City leads it 2-1, but Seward County looking to split and go 2-2 here as they lead 12-0 over Garden City here in the bottom of the third. Number 26 of Rodriguez. He line drives it right to, that was the number 5.
The center fielder, number 14, Mason Mitchell.
So Rodriguez gets the first out, and now Mason Mitchell up to bat. Ball fouled off. That one lined off right to Gallardo. Shortstop throw to first. And there goes the second out off of Mason Mitchell. That's now the number 5 of Kyle Jamison up to bat.
The shortstop number 5, Kyle Jamison.
And Garden City just can't get anything going this afternoon. Pitch was called a strike. Swing and a miss there, 0-2 on the count. That pitch too low. Pitch on the inside, Jamison had to back up on it. Yeah. pitch on the outside. Now Jameson on a full count. Jameson, line drive right out into left field. It's going to fall into a gap. And Jameson will make it a double. Now go triple. Can he get an infield home run? No, he'll stop at third. But Jameson on a triple hit there. Now we head back to the top of the lineup. It'll be Glosson. Glosson had a strikeout back in the first, and that's all he's had so far this afternoon. So Seward County was on track to go for a no-hitter. Now Jameson finally gets a hit up for Garden City and avoids that as Glosson on a swing and a miss starts off on an 0-1 count with two outs bearing down on Garden City. Glosson pops that one up. It's going to go foul as that was the number five of Armijo on the run, trying to get that out, but that ball is going to fall into Garden City's dugout. Glosson on a swing and a hit. Line drive to Gallardo on the shortstop, and then throw to first, gets the third and final out here in the third. One man left on, heading to the top of the fourth. Garden City leads 12-0 over Garden City here on the Brockbuster Sports Network.
Leading out for Seward here in the top of the fourth inning is the right fielder number 11, Peter Goley.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, Seward County leading 12-0 over Garden City. As now the number 11 of Peter Goldie, or Goldie rather, line drive right to Muniz, the second. He'll contribute for the first out on Seward County in the top of the fourth. Goldie had a three-run RBI back in the first, and then walked to first and was left on in the second here in the fourth game. Garcia on the slider gets a strike. Burbick, the designated hitter for Seward County, up to bat. Now Garcia on the change up there, and it's hit out into a gap in left field.
The shortstop, number 24, George Van Hurtel.
It's now the number 24 of Gallardo. Up to bat for Seward County. He had a three-run home run back in the first and then struck out on a swing in the second. Pitch fouled off back behind the Seward County dugout. So 1-1 on the count for him. Ball fouled off behind home plate. That ball popped out right in the right field. It's got a lot of wind behind it. It's going to hit the top of the wall. Almost went for a home run. So Berbick will make it all the way to third, and it'll be a double play there for Gallardo. As now the number five of Armijo.
The baseman number five, Richard Armijo.
Will be up to bat for Seward County with runners on third and second. And Seward County trying to increase this lead even more. They lead 12-0 and have only allowed one hit from Garden City. That pitch too high. That pitch on the inside almost hitting Armijo in the thigh. So 2-0 on the count for him. Garden City only needs to get two runs to prevent Seward County from run ruling them before the fifth. But right now that seems almost impossible the way Seward County has been playing, as that one smashed out in the center field. That one's going to be fielded off. But Seward County will add another run. It's Berbick. We'll bring it in. Gallardo will advance to third. And Armijo will be caught out in center field.
The center fielder, number 22, KB Warner.
Now head coach for Garden City, Chris Finnegan, in his 14th season, heads out to the mound to talk to Garcia, and he's going to call for the bullpen on the Garden City side. So we'll take a timeout, be back with more Region 6 baseball here on the Rockbuster Sports Network. Your score, 13-0 in favor of Seward County.
Like this is what you like. life like, trying to live the life right. People really know you, cause your mind's like, type right. This is like a movie, but it's really very lifelike. Every single night, right? Every single fight, right? I was looking at the ground and I don't even like lights. I was screaming at my daddy, told me in Christ like. I was screaming at the referee, just like Mike. Looking for a bright light, single with your life like. Riding on a white bike, feeling like a sight fight. Pressing on the gas, but over for a night like. Screaming at my daddy, told me in Christ.
Now pitching for the Mustangs, number 12, Jake Gimble.
Back here on the Rockbuster Sports Network. New pitcher now for Garden City. It's been an ongoing struggle for them out of the bullpen this afternoon. As now the number 12 of Jake Gimble, the right-handed pitcher, 6'1 freshman from Morrison, Colorado. Now taking over the mound for Raul Garcia. Here in the bottom of the fourth. Now, back at the top of the lineup here, will be the number 22 of Warner. That one smashed out in the right field. It's got a lot of wind behind it. And they're going to call it fair. A double home run for Warner off of Gimble's. Only his fifth pitch. And Seward just increasing this lead over Garden City. Now the number 8 of Johnson will be up
the
to bat.
Baseman, number 8, Johnson.
Garden City has two outs on Seward County, and that's been the biggest struggle for them also this afternoon. Being able to get two outs and just been struggling to get the third out throughout the inning. One of the biggest examples was back in the first game in that fourth inning. Garden City had two outs for more than six of the batters that came back up to the bat and still allowed to contribute four more runs for Seward County. So Garden City hasn't been able to close out at all this afternoon. That pitch fouled off. So Johnson on an 0-2. That pitch gonna hit Johnson. Umpire is going to talk to Johnson about it, ask where it hit. Looked like it hit Johnson. Umpire say no, it didn't. So Johnson will stay up to bat. Now the Seward County head coach is going to come from third base and talk it out with the home plate umpire. Now both umpires are going to meet midway in the infield to talk this one out. Controversial call there. Now Finnegan charging towards the home plate umpire. And Finnegan is not happy. He's got to be careful here with the home plate umpire. You can hear the home crowd saying that Johnson swung. And Finnegan's going to get his word in with the home plate umpire. And now both umpires going to be coming back to the home plate. Finnegan looks like he's done talking here. He's got to be careful. He might get thrown out.
You're awful.
Hearing
You're awful.
Controversial calls from the home crowd. Finnegan's going to make his way back into the dugout and probably where he should stay for the rest of the game if he wants to stay in this game.
The catcher number 14.
But in his defense, everything's not been going his way this afternoon for his Bronkbuster baseball squad. And now Finnegan going to head out to the mound and look for a changeup. Let's take it with him. Take a 1 minute timeout. Seward County leads 15-0 over Garden City here in the top of the fourth on the Bronkbuster Sports Network. Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network. Marler throw to first, try to get Johnson out. Can't get there in time. So the initial call for Johnson, I thought it was Johnson got hit by the ball and they were going to walk him on that 0-2 count. But then the debate was if he swung or not on that 0-2 count, as now Grant puts it all the way back towards the 410 mark, and beautiful catch by Mason Mitchell to get Garden City out of this tough inning. But going back to the Johnson situation, Johnson, I thought he got hit by the ball, and that's what the controversial call was for. Did he get hit or not, or was it a hit on the bat and would it have been a foul ball and he kept going? But the actual debate with Finnegan and the third base coach for Seward County was if he swung the bat or not. The umpire is finally saying he did not swing, and it would have been a walk as he got hit by it. So the debate was, Johnson did get hit by the ball, but they were trying to see if Johnson had swung the bat fully, and both umpires saying no, he did not, so it allowed for the walk, and well, the rest was history for Finnegan as he charged the mound and hashed his words out with the home plate umpire. And Finnegan's still in the game, never got thrown out of that, but that's what happened there with the Johnson call. So Johnson left on first as we head into the bottom of the fourth. Your score 15-0, Seward County leading big time over Garden City. Definitely not how Garden City wanted to end their regular season at home in Williams Stadium. But Seward County looking to go for the split here in the four-game series. Garden City winning the first two games back on the 6th, 8-5 in the first game, 17-5 in the second, and then Garden City drops the third game earlier this afternoon, 14-3, and getting ready to drop this game more than likely as Seward has just opened up a big gap between Garden City, 15-0, your score right now. So for Garden City up to bat, it will be the number 8 of Ryan Munez, I believe. Would be Munez up to bat and Gardner in the hole.
Leading off the Busters here in the bottom of the fourth inning, the second baseman,
Gardner on deck.
Munez.
Munez had a pop out into center field back in the first inning, hasn't been back to the plate since. Here in the final game of the four game series, that pitch fouled off. That pitch on the inside. Make it 1-1. Seward County 4th in the Jayhawk Conference, Garden City in 7th. As Seward County now 24-23 overall in the season. And now 19-12 in the conference. Garden City now dropping to 21-26 overall in the season and 11-20 in the Jayhawk Conference. That pitch too low. 2-2 on the count. That one line drive through the mound and up center field as Munez will get the single. That's now the number 25, Will Gardner, up to bat for Garden City.
The right field number 25, Will Gardner.
Line drive up to the shortstop. That was Gallardo out there on the shortstop, stumbling it up, and now allows Gardner on the single hit. Advances Munez out to second, as now the number 39 of Ramos. Be up to bat for Garden City. Ramos had a line drive thrown out on first back in the second inning in his only at bat. Now throw to second, try to get the out on Munez and can't get there in time. So now Grant and Turner are going to talk it out there on the mound for a quick second.
Okay, good. Because I guess what's funny.
Going to change up their game plan. And they got two runners now on first and second. Most Garden City's really had most pressure they've put on this afternoon here in the fourth game. Now swinging a hit out into right field. That one's going to go foul as Brovere went on the charging run, try to get that out. Can't get there in time as it went out into the Seward County bullpen. So 0-1 on Ramos. Pitch there, strike called. Ramos thought about swinging on it, but brought the bat back. And now he'll be on an 0-2 count after looking. That pitch almost hitting Ramos, and a strike three call. That was a beautiful curve ball. It looked like it was going to almost hit Ramos, and brought it back in. And Ramos was strike out looking.
The first baseman, number 7, Tyler Barr.
Now, the first baseman, number 7, Tyler Barth, up to bat. Barth hasn't had a good day either. Line drive out to third base, thrown to first, and thrown out. Here in the fourth game, back in the first game this afternoon. Barth didn't have much on his name either. Line pop out to left field and got caught out, and then line drive out in the center and thrown out as well in the fourth, back in the first game. So Barth hasn't had a typical Tyler Barth afternoon, to say. He hasn't been able to get on any bases so far this afternoon. That pitch on the outside, too low. Make it 1-1 on the count. So Muna's out on second, Gardner on first. They've been there now for the past two batters. There's the pitch there. That one hits the plate. And it'll make it 2-1 on the count. That one a swing and it fouled off behind home plate. Make it 2-2 now for Tyler Barth. Seward County holding Garden City to three hits, no runs. That one popped out right in the center field. Should be an easy catch there. It is. Now get the throw in to third as Munez will advance. So Munez advances and Will Gardner will stay on first. Now Garden City got runners in the corners. That's now the catcher for Garden City, Jeff Marlowe. Up to bat.
The catcher number 30.
Marlowe was left on back in the second inning in the first game this afternoon, then popped out in the left field, caught out. Then in the fourth game alone, Marlowe line drive to shortstop back in the second inning in the fourth and final game. That's all he's been able to contribute for Garden City this afternoon. Two outs for Garden City, runners in the corners. It's Munez and Gardner. There's the pitch dropping low. Start off with a 1-0 count. Seward County has went 6-4-2-3 in the first, second, third, and fourth inning, holding Garden City to nothing so far, making it 15-0. Your score, 13 hits for Seward, only 3 for Garden City. No errors. It's that pitch on the outside, make it 2-0 now. Turner on a 2-0 windup. Popped out right to third base. That's Amio out there. And he'll get the throw to first. And it'll be a double play technically. Marlowe gets thrown out at first for the third and final out. But tag up from Amio on third will send Garden City into the top of the fifth. Your score 15-0 here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
It starts with pain.
I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. I'm trying to explain it due time.
All I know, time is a valuable thing.
No runs, one hit, no one error, and 2 minutes left on. We have a top of the fifth. Seward County leads 15-0.
Remembering all the times you fought with me.
back here on the Bronc Buster Sports Network.
Seward here in the top of the fifth.
Back up to bat here in the top of the fifth. Seward County could really put it away here.
Bonvere.
As now the number 35 of Brayden Bonvere up to bat. First pitch, strike called by the home plate umpire. It's number 12 of Gimble out there now. Fourth pitcher here in the fourth game alone. Garden City went through five pitchers back in the first game. That pitch on a changeup, swinging it back in, strike called. 0-2 on Boisvert. And a swing and a miss, Gimble. And a throw to first there. Gimble gets his first strikeout of the afternoon on Boisvert. On a swing and a miss, Boisvert, one of those that have contributed really well this afternoon for Seward County. Got a run back in the first, was left on in the second, popped out to left, got caught out in the third, didn't have an at-bat. Now that's the number three of A.J. Folds out to center left field and be caught out there. So Garden City going to try to go three up, three down to get in the bottom of the fifth and get the bats
right,
going
number 11, Peter Golding.
For them. But Boisvert back in the first game had a single home run and then a run in the fourth inning back in the first game. A.J. Folds, another one that has contributed well, had a strikeout in the third, but two runs and a three-run home run in the second. That's now the number 11 of Peter Goldie, up to bat. He had a three-run RBI in the first and a walk to first in the second inning, but was left on and then a hit out to first in the fourth. That one, line drive to the shortstop, throw to first to Barth, and the out call. Garden City goes three up, three down here in the top of the fifth, and now it's all up to the Bronc Busters. They trail by 15 to Seward County in the fourth and final game of the four-game series here on the Bronc Buster Sports Network.
Leading off the Busters, bring the ball to the fifth inning, the third base with number 26, Ibrahim Rodriguez.
Back here on the Bronc Buster Sports Network, Garden City goes three up, three down in the top of the fifth to get try to get the bats going, and there it starts right there. Ibrahim Rodriguez gets drilled by Turner's pitch, and Rodriguez will be put on first. That's now the number 14 of
Mason Mitchell.
Up to bat. Mitchell had a pop out, caught out in the third inning. This is his only second at bat, as Garden City hasn't really been able to rotate through the lineup much today at all. As Seward County has held Garden City to only two at bats per player. Seward County, on the other hand, let's not get into it. We could sit here all afternoon and talk about how many players have had at-bat opportunities this afternoon. Seward County leads 15-0 over Garden City. There's the pitch, strike called. Swinging a hit, Mason Mitchell puts it out right in the right field, and it's going to drop. And Garden City going to get runners on third and second. Now into scoring position off of Mitchell's double hit. That's now number five of Kyle Jameson up to bat. And Garden City needs to get six runs here to stay in contention and go into extra innings. And if Garden City gets a run here, expect Seward County to go for a pitching change, more than likely, as Jameson now up to bat. It's the pitch there on the inside, a strike called. Jameson was left out on third, back in the third inning. This is only at bat. Now swinging a hit right out into right field. It's going to go foul.
Home run.
We go five.
Finnegan going to have a word with Jameson now. Garden City trying to make something happen or even just get some points on the board versus Seward County trying to avoid the shutout. There's the pitch, swing and a hit right in between the third base and shortstop gap. It's going to bring in the first run. That's Rodriguez. And a slide in to second base and be called safe. Jameson getting that extra base. So Rodriguez will be brought in on an RBI. And Mason Mitchell out on third. And you got two Bronkbusters in scoring position still as we head to the back to the top of the lineup as the number four of Glosson up to bat. Glosson struck out in the first and then had a pop out into shallow infield to get thrown out. Now another pop out right to second. Gets thrown out at first, but it'll bring in another runner. Now the number eight of Ryan Muniz back up to bat. So that'll bring in Mason Mitchell. And it'll advance Kyle Jameson over to third. But Garden City with two outs. Excuse me, with one out. Swinging a hit right to third base. There's the second out, double play. And that'll do it. Or excuse me,
two runs, two
correction.
Runs, and nobody left on. We go to the top of the sixth. Seward leads 15.
So top of the sixth, forgot. In the KJCCC, the second game in the series, you go to all seven innings. So 15-2, your score. Garden City gets some runs up on the board finally. We end at the top of the sixth. Seward County leads here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
Seward here in the top of the six. The designated hit number one, Sam Berberick.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, top of the six. Silly mistake on my end. I forgot that in the Kansas Jayhawk Conference, you go to seven innings in the second game of the series. So top of the six, Seward County still leads 15-2 on a 13-point lead over Garden City, finally getting two runs up on the board. Now a pop-up. That's the number one of Berberick. And he'll be caught out for the first out.
The shortstop, number 24, George Gallardo.
It's now the number 24 of Gallardo. Back up to bat. He had a three-run home run back in the first, struck out swinging in the second, then contributed a run in the fourth for all of his at-bat opportunities this afternoon. That pitch called strike there. Swing and a hit right through first and second base, and that'll be a single for Gallardo. It's now the number five of Armijo, back up to bat for Seward County. Got thrown out at first, back in the first inning. Got caught out in the double play in the third. Pop up into left in the fourth. That's all of his three at-bat opportunities. Hasn't had much to put down on his name here in the fourth and final game. So that pitch on the outside. Number 12 of Gimble still out on the mound. Garden City struggled through the bullpen all day. So that ball is fouled off. Make it 1-1 on the count. Here's the 1-1 windup pitch. Fastball fouled off. Gimble had a strikeout back in the fifth on Beauvais. There's the pitch, swing and fouled off again. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss. He's going to run. Marlowe throw to second. And it's going to be bounced off. No good there. So Gimble gets a second strikeout of the afternoon. But it comes with the price as Gallardo will steal over to second.
Center field number 22, KB Warner.
Marlowe not having a good day either behind the plate for Garden City. He hasn't been able to get any of his balls over to second base or first on a steal attempt. That one fouled off behind the grandstands. It's number 22 of KP Warner now back at the top of the lineup for Seward County. Sunny and windy afternoon here in southwest Kansas. Temperatures starting to drop here at Williams Stadium. Another gorgeous afternoon for Bronkbuster Athletics. That one, line drive, put up really high, and it's going to fall right before the 375 mark on the wall. And Seward County puts up another run as Gallardo will bring it in off of Warner's RBI.
The second baseman, number 8, Case Johnson.
As now Finnegan going to head to the mound. And expect a call to the bullpen. Yep, there it is. We'll take it with them here. Your score 16-2 as Garden City going to go through their fifth and final pitching changeup this afternoon here on the Brockbuster Sports Network.
Thank you.
Now pitching for Busters, number 18, Trey Shortfinger.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, top of the sixth, Garden City going for their fifth and final pitching change of the afternoon. That's now the number 18 of Schwarfager out on the mound for Garden City. This is the 10th pitching change of the afternoon. We've seen the same pitcher twice in both games. That was the number 24, Noah McCandless. He's the only pitcher that's pitched twice this afternoon, back in the first and second game this here in the series. So it's number 8 of Johnson. He's scored all three of his at-bats. Didn't score on his fourth at-bat. Scored in the first, second, and third. It's the pitch, swing and a miss on Johnson. 2-2 on the count now. Still have Warner over on second after his RBI hit to bring Gallardo in. Garden City has two outs, a strikeout on Amicho and Barabic. And a strike three call there on this curve gets Garden City out of the inning. We head to the bottom of the sixth. Your score, 16-2 on the Rockbuster Sports Network.
One run, two hits, no errors, and one man left on the top of the sixth.
So, Paulie Clergy.
Like before, these calloused hands and all this work. We sit up at flats, acting like we live forever, getting high and skipping class. Yeah, I reckon we were heathens, but in her eyes we were saints. See her through the pines.
So I collapse, I'm spilling this wax, long as you feel me to the day that I drop. You'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause what
I'm doing, I forgot to say, here with Bobby the Sixth, the right field, number 25, Will Gardner.
Subliminal thoughts, when I'm gonna stop spinning and win.
bottom of the sixth for Garden City, as now the number eight of, or excuse me, the 25 of Will Gardner up to bat for Garden City. As the Bronkbusters trail 16-2 here, going into seven innings. And Garden City's got a lot of work to do if they're even going to attempt to catch Seward on this 14-point deficit. Garden City finally got some scoring going back in the fifth inning after Rodriguez Mitchell brought it in on runs from an RBI from Jameson. That's it. Two runs for Garden City this whole fourth game. Seward County went 6 in the first, 4 in the second, 2 in the third, 3 in the fourth, nothing in the fifth, 1 in the sixth. As that one popped up, it's going to hit the top of the press box. Garden City's went 0 in the first, second, third, fourth, and finally 2 runs in the fifth. Let's see what they can do here in the bottom of the sixth. Here's the pitch, curve ball, fouled off. Two and two count there, make it full count now for Gardner. Turner trying to put on a clinic here for Seward County. And that one's going to be balled off, and it'll be a walk for Gardner. That's now the number 39 of Ramos.
The designated hitter number 39, Miguel Ramos.
Line drive right past mound, go for the double play there, and Seward will get it. Gardner gets thrown out at second, and Ramos gets thrown out at first on the double play.
The first baseman, number 7, Tyler Barth.
Now the number 7 of Tyler Barth up to bat for Garden City. First ball there, too low. Swing and a fouled off. Make it 1-1 count now for Tyler Barth. Swing and a miss on Barth, make it 1-2 now. There's the attempt curve ball on the outside. So 2-2 on the count with two outs here for Tyler Barth. Here's the pitch, swing fouled off. Curveball attempt there on the outside. So full count now for Tyler Barth. Two outs pending. Turner's pitching is definitely starting to slow down here as he's been in the game all afternoon. And strike three called, looking there on Barth. So we head now to the top of the seventh. Your score, 16-2. Garden City trails by 14 here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
Leading off for Seward here at the top of the seventh inning was the catcher number 14, Wyatt Grant.
Back here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network, Garden City and Seward County in the fourth and final game of the four-game series. As Seward County leads 16-2. Now the number 14 of Grant up to bat. There's a slider ball, strike called. So now Grant on a 1-1 count. So that's the number 18 of Schwartfeger out there. And a swing tipped off, foul ball. Make it 1-2. He's got two strikeouts so far this afternoon. I had one back in the fifth on Overett and then on Amigo back in the sixth. So 1-2 on the count for Grant. There's that slider ball again. That one too low. Grant had a run back in the second, was left on third in the third inning. Now that one popped up right into shallow center right field. And Grant will get on the first base. It's now the number 35 of Braden Boisvert. Bavere had a run in the first, left on first in the second, got thrown out in the third, struck out swinging in the fifth. Now here he is in the seventh. And a strike called there. Didn't call the strike there. It looked like it was going to go on the strike, but must have been two inside for Boisvert. So 1-1 on the count now. Right. the lead off over on first. Gets back in time. Schwarfegger hasn't really worried about any runners trying to steal. He's been focused on trying to get outs for Garden City. That pitch too low. Ball fouled off by Boisvert. So 2-2 on the count for him. That one's swinging a hit right to left field. And it'll be, should be an easy catch, and it is. So Boisvert gets caught out in left field. That's now the number three of AJ Folds up to bat. That's Grant on first base for Seward County. Swinging a hit right to the shortstop for the second. Throw to first. Double play for Garden City. Garden City makes the double play on Grant and Folds. As we head to the bottom of the seventh, your score 16-2. Garden City running out of time to make anything happen over Seward County here on the Bronkbuster Sports Network.
No runs, one hit, no errors, and nobody left on the top of the seventh.
Cadillac comes on the hood. My buddy Frankie had his dad hook him up good. Girls smile when we roll by. They hop in the back and we cruise to the riverside. Wow, never gonna grow up. Wow, never gonna slow down. Wow, we were shining like lights in the dark in the middle of a rock show.
Do or die, Garden City in the bottom of the seventh. They trail by 14 after a 3-and-up double play. Back in the top of the seventh on Seward County. Now it's a new pitcher as Rainbow Bear now out on the mound for Seward County. So that'll change how things line up out in the outfield. Now swinging a hit right to second base. There goes the first out. It's Marlowe. As now the number 26 of Ibrahim Rodriguez up to bat. Rodriguez got the first run in for Garden City back in the fifth after an RBI hit in from Jamison.
The third baseman, number 26, Ibrahim Rodriguez.
The anybody's going to keep Garden City alive right now, it could be Ibrahim Rodriguez. So Boisvert on the windup pitch, swing and a miss there on a fastball. So Boisvert going to try to come in and go three up, three down, and try to get Seward County out of here and back on the road towards Liberal. Second pitch, swing and a miss. Haven't seen Boisvert on the mound all day. Curious to see what he's going to put up and try to put in a quick relief for the Saints. As they lead by 14, no pressure from Garden City. That one hit really hard out into left field. It's going to drop and be caught out. Second out. Garden City's time is running out. It's now the number 14 of Mason Mitchell. Up to him to see if he can get anything going for the Bronkbusters. Mitchell had to pop out in the left field back in the third inning and then contributed for one of two runs for Garden City after that RBI hit from Jameson in the fifth. That pitch too high on the inside. Almost hitting Mitchell in the helmet. Boisvert on the 1-0. That one's too high again. Fastball, swing and a miss. Two and one with two outs on Garden City in their final attempt to make anything happen on Seward County. Almost impossible at this point. There's the pitch from Boisvert and strike call. So 2-2 on Mason Mitchell. Here's the 2-2. Too low there. Mitchell thought about it, brought the back in time. So now on a full count with two outs, this is it. Probably one of the biggest pitch for Boisvert in his pitching career this season. Swing and a hit right to first base, that's gonna do it. Garden City drops the final two games in the four-game series with Seward County in a final score, 16-2.
16, Busters 2.
And Garden City now dropping to 21-26 overall in the season and 11-21 in the conference. Seward County improves to 25-23 overall and 20-12 in the conference. That's going to do it for our broadcast this afternoon. I'm Donald Janicek saying so long and good night. You've been watching Region 6 Baseball.